welcome to this week's episode of Let's Chat with Curry and Adrian. I am Curry Terrell. With me, as always, Adrian McMillan.
What's up?
Delilah.
Question from Seattle.
And then she'd play like, I can be your hero, baby. I mean, as always, now you listen, it's like moves like Jagger.
Right.
A lot of Maroon 5. Delilah loves Maroon 5.
That's not romantic, I don't think.
How's life?
It's fine.
Yeah? You had a good week?
We're live from DeLongpre.
Yeah. I like that we go back and forth.
Yeah.
It's kind of fun.
Mm-hmm.
You don't sound convinced.
We have a studio audience of cats.
We have a studio audience of cats and Patrick.
Yes.
And the windows are open, so technically the streets are listening.
The whole neighborhood, Spalding Square, is listening.
What'd you get into this week?
We saw Lord of the Rings yesterday.
How was that?
Fabulous.
At Cinespia.
Cinespia.
But not the cemetery one, the one at the park.
Yes. Would you went to for the ring?
That's the only time I've been there, yeah. The ring.
It's fun.
If you gave me $100, I could not point out where we were on a map.
That sucks.
Where is that in Los Angeles?
Like downtown, basically.
Oh.
Fringe downtown.
Mm-hmm.
Right outside of Dodger Stadium.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I sort of have an idea, I guess.
Yeah. It was great. We did that. We saw a lot of movies this week.
Saw a lot of movies.
And that was it.
Yeah. Can I speak on Cher?
You can speak on Cher.
Monday, I went to see the premiere of Bob Mackie's documentary, done by the same guy who did Scatter My Ashes at Bergdorf's. Did you ever watch that? Oh,
I think I did.
Which was also good.
Yeah.
And Cher was there. RuPaul was there. Carol Burnett was there. Pink was there.
Wow. And more in the audience.
And more. Vicki Lawrence was there. Donna Mills. Caroline Ray.
Wasn't there a drag queen there?
Gigi Good was there, yeah. In the general admission line with us.
Wow.
Stars, they're just like us.
Yeah. I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. That's probably what she was thinking.
Yeah. I was like, why are you in the normal line?
Yeah.
You're a legend.
Right.
Do you know who Gigi Good is?
Couldn't tell you.
Yeah. She was really good on Drag Race.
Wow.
Yeah. Anyway, it was ultimate LA experience.
Yeah.
One of those where you're just sitting there and you're like, how did I end up here?
But it was meant to be.
It was definitely meant to be.
Yeah.
It really was. It was very cool. Just, you know, people like that, they are there and then they go away. You know what I mean? Like Carol Burnett, she is in her 90s.
Yeah.
So just being able to sit there and listen to her talk and tell these stories, even though it's all stuff you've heard and seen before, it just...
To see it in the flesh.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible. It was pretty... And Cher, obviously. I mean, that was just... Hearing her speak...
In person.
And stand... Like, when we walked in, she was standing in the lobby.
Yeah.
And we were just like... All of us just froze. Right. Like, oh my God, Cher.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Anyway, peak LA experience. Top five, probably.
That's... You can't beat that.
No. No. Also, can we talk about Bridgerton for like 2.5 seconds?
I'll be silent.
Bridgerton came back this week. 4 episodes. It's going to be 8 total. The second comeback in the middle of June. This season is about Penelope and Colin, which we learned on the billboard stands for...
Pollen.
their what's the word?
Ship name.
Ship name is Pollen. Love. My favorite thing about Bridgerton is that people get famous and they ditch the show. So that is my ultimate takeaway every time I watch it. Is like, I hate that, you know, eventually there's like 7 books. So they're like going to do season for all of the Bridgerton kids. So like by the end, is it just going to be the 2 youngest and then all the adults from the original, the rest of them will be too big to keep doing it? Why won't you watch Bridgerton?
I could not care less.
TV stuff, I really can never gauge with you.
Yeah. You said yesterday or the day before,
it's not for me. No, I know, but you are a curious person by nature, and I feel like you like
not
to
for
be.
That.
Yeah. I love it. I absolutely love it.
You were shocked more that Patrick likes it.
Yeah. I am shocked that Patrick likes it. Right. Yeah, he hasn't watched it. So.
Yeah. Then it did come out yesterday.
It did. But he didn't watch the second season or Queen Charlotte. I did watch
Queen Charlotte. He did.
He didn't watch the second season. There's 3 seasons.
Yeah.
So, I mean.
Yeah. Yeah. But the new episodes of this one did come out yesterday. That's 4 hours of TV.
Okay. And we've watched 10 hours of movies in the last 2 days.
I'm just saying, it's different.
Everybody take a deep breath. They came out on Thursday.
Okay.
So that's 3 days now. And I watched them. And I will defend it to the end. If I like it, so be it.
Great.
The first movie we saw together this week... Actually, we're not going to start there. The second movie we saw together this week, Back to Black, which is a movie about Amy Winehouse, her career. So it doesn't go from like childhood. It's not that kind of movie. Mm. It's like basically the start of her career till her death.
Yeah.
Stars Marissa Abella as Amy Winehouse, Jack O'Connell, Eddie Moran, and Leslie Manville, star of our favorite movie of all time, Mrs. Harris Goes to Paris.
The Mrs. Harris.
The Mrs. Harris is Amy Winehouse's grandmother and is, I think, younger than the man playing her father.
I agree.
That, when you brought that up in the car the other day, yeah. I haven't got that off my mind.
It's the only fault with the movie that I have.
You loved it, so I want you to talk first.
It's just great. Everybody's a hater. You're a hater. Patrick's a hater. Everybody who said it's bad is a hater. I think it's like it's almost the way that I am perceiving it as like hate bombing. Like, you know how people do that with like
Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, or like super conservative or super liberal media movies, whatever. Same idea. Like, I think Amy Winehouse is so fresh in her mind, which I get. It's hard to wrap your head around somebody portraying her.
Yeah.
Because she really didn't die that long ago. It was like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Or a little bit longer, actually. So that's why I think people don't like it. Ultimately, it's like a perfectly great music biopic.
I just would like to say I have in no way communicated to you or to anyone that I didn't like the movie.
You made, when Denise looked at you at the end of the movie, you made a face where you're like, like that. That's literally what you did.
You could not have seen me.
I made eye contact with you. She said, did you love it?
And I said, eh.
No, you went, that was the noise you made.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then you made it in your review that I did not like the movie.
Correct.
I, in quotes, hated the movie, which I have not said, and I actually said I liked it. So you have this relationship with me and the movie that I don't even have. I liked it fine.
Yeah.
I thought it was a perfectly good movie.
Yeah.
The script had some moments that were painful. But
like what, though?
I just think they didn't want to go anywhere. It's the same thing with respect. The thing with all of these music movies is they don't want to disrespect the artist, which I understand.
Right.
So they just sort of dance around. Like, her father and her had a perfectly adequate relationship, which in real life they didn't. Her and Blake went on one date, which was 20 minutes of the movie, and then she was obsessed with him and, like, crazy, boy crazy about him. They had literally just met. From our perspective, they tried to tell too many things.
It is a narrative movie. It is not a documentary. We have a very good documentary that tells the story of her life.
Correct, but it is tackling the story of her life, so it's okay to focus on three things more in depth than 20 things on a very surface level.
We did say it follows a very similar formula, I think, more than even respect Bob Marley, the Bob Marley movie. Almost to a T.
Where they didn't want to go there.
Where they... No. Where they... She is experiencing something, and then she writes a song.
Yeah.
She's experiencing something, and they write... So that, I could feel, gets a little tired, but there was something about the way that it was made that really sucked me in. Again, specifically with her and Mrs. Harris, when they had like a 10-minute scene together.
Yes.
Stunning.
That
the
was
last
lovely.
20 minutes, amazing. I really, it sold me. It really, it hit it out of the park for me. I think maybe, I don't know, like, I knew, I thought it was going to be bad. And then it just, it made me, I had to work to love it. And then I loved it at the end. I was like, oh, I need to stop convincing myself that this is a bad movie. Because everybody keeps saying it's bad.
Yeah, well, reviews, we always decide, they really do not affect how we go into a movie.
Sure.
I mean, you have made it up in your mind that I didn't like it, and literally every person that texted me, I said, it was good. Caroline, I texted her the minute we got out. It was better than I thought it was going to be. But you
but
think
did you
I
say
hate
it was good?
I said it was good. In the thing, I said it is a good movie.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know how to fight with you about if I like Amy Winehouse or not. I liked it fine. It was fine.
Also,
I love pop culture. It's a movie about Amy Winehouse. So at the end of the day, even if it was terrible, which it was not, I liked it. I had a good time with it.
Patrick really thought it was awful. And that, I think, also is what I'm dragging into this, which I shouldn't.
Yeah. So maybe turn your head around, look him in the eyes, and direct those lasers at him instead of me, who's just an oversaying. It was pretty good. I thought it was good. I would watch it again.
I don't believe that for a second.
I would. I would definitely watch it again. I enjoyed it.
Yeah. Yeah.
God. It did feel like a Lifetime movie.
You see,
that's okay.
Curry could not be more wrong.
And that's why we have a podcast, so we can discuss our differing opinions, which we will momentarily with The Pool Man, which Adrian slept through and gave 3 stars. Anything else you want to say about Amy?
I think, honestly, don't read their reviews. If you've read them already, okay.
Yeah.
But don't read their reviews. Go in with a fresh brain.
Yeah.
And enjoy.
Yeah.
I think really, honestly, this movie is made for people who don't live in LA or New York. Like, it's made for people who are familiar with her, who don't know a lot about her. We, again, are too plugged in. So that's why people hate it, in my opinion.
Well, first of all, I don't like to think any movie is not for me. Every movie that I can pay
Aggro Drift is not for you from Harmony Korine.
But it should be.
But it isn't. That's just the matter of fact. It's not.
But this isn't Aggro Drift. This is a New Line.
But that's what I'm saying.
Focus features movie, whatever, directed by the woman who did 50 Shades.
Correct.
So it should be attainable to me.
Amy Winehouse and a movie about her is not for everybody in cities that are so obsessed with movie making and everything being perfect.
Yeah. I didn't need it to be perfect. I think ultimately, here's the last 2 things I'll say. And then if you want to say
you'll have
fine.
The last word.
No, I said if you want to say more, that's fine.
No, I'm
too.
Saying you will have the last word.
Oh, I think what would have made this movie better to me is if they had focused in on like the story of Blake and Amy, or the story of her career, or the story of, and just focused on like a piece of the puzzle instead of really blurry pieces of the whole puzzle.
I disagree. That's my last word. I have the last
word. And that's
word.
Okay.
Next.
But I will say one last thing.
Clip.
A clip. How sad.
Of course.
And what an amazing album.
Of course.
I mean, literally, that album is unreal. Period. Also, Kelly doing karaoke with her, I cannot stop thinking
That's
about
crazy.
It. Okay, next we're going to talk about If. I'll go very quickly. If, starring Ryan Reynolds, Kaylee Fleming is little girl, and a voice cast of Steve Carell, Phoebe Waller-Bridge, which I just wrote, I misspelled in my phone and wrote Phobe. P-H-O-B.
I don't think it's Phoebe Waller-Bridges.
What is it? Phoebe Waller-Bridge.
Bridge. Phoebe Bridgers is somebody else.
Yeah, it's Phoebe Waller-Bridge.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
It is about...
And Emily Blunt.
And she's in it for 1 minute.
And Louis Gossett Jr.
Okay,
just
there's
died.
Like 40 people in,
I'm,
in the
I'm
movie.
Just thinking of the people on the poster.
It is a movie about imaginary friends... And this little girl whose job it is to repair imaginary friends with their kids that they, like, were responsible for. As you say, it is a movie for babies. Period. Mm. They decided, instead of making anything that... here's the thing. We have lost the era of, like, family films that are also... Like, think about Jumanji. Mm. Or even the new Jumanji. It is fun for a 5-year-old. It's fun for a 20-year-old. We don't have those kinds of movies much anymore.
No.
If I think that they just rely on the fact that everybody in it is really famous. People really love Ryan Reynolds and John Krasinski, who is also in it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to spoil the whole movie. The little girl's imaginary friend is Ryan Reynolds. So everybody else has imaginary friends. They're like a unicorn, a stuffed bear, Rainbow. And then this little girl, her imaginary friend is Ryan Reynolds. Just like being him, his like Deadpool sarcastic humor self. I also think like the emotional manipulation of them trying to make it about like her sick father and then never really getting into that. Yeah, it just really wasn't good. It really tells us that if you are a certain level of fame, you can get anything made. John Krasinski can get any movie he wants to get made, made.
That's pretty shocking.
It is pretty shocking. A Quiet Place was really good, though.
Yeah, I won't be watching If, that's for sure.
I don't think anybody should be, unless you have a baby, like a three-year-old that wants to put something on. I think it is the perfect movie for them.
Yeah.
But it wasn't really funny. That's, I think, also the problem.
You said the person next to you was crying.
The person next to me was crying. So it could just be me, but it really was not for me. Yeah. What's the what makes you decide to see an animated movie or not see an animated movie?
If the trailer is good.
Yeah.
I'm so obsessed with trailers. The If trailer didn't do anything for me. I thought it was dumb.
I totally agree. I totally agree with that. The next thing we're going to talk about is The Strangers Chapter 1, which we just saw, literally fresh out the gate. We started on a high and are going down, I think.
We saw a lot of bad movies.
Not Amy. We're not there yet. Stranger Chapter 1 stars Madeline Pesch and Froy Gutierrez, who is from Cruel Summer and Teen Wolf. Madeline Pesch from Riverdale. Stranger Chapter 1 is essentially the exact same plot as The Strangers with Liv Tyler, where two people are in a house and people come to get them and like torture them and mess with their minds and period. The old one, classic. Mm-hmm. Absolutely classic, fun, stupid horror movie. Mm. Scary. There's, you know, there's nothing to it. The new one.
Pathetic. Unscary. Boring.
It's essentially the same scenes, most of them, from the other one. Except there was something different. I think also the Scott Speedman and Liv Tyler are much better actors.
Yeah.
The boy, thank God he's pretty. That's all I thought, is you have really gotten by on your looks, because you are not good, friend.
It was painful.
I think I was thrown off by the idea that in the poster in the trailer said, find out how the strangers became the strangers. Yeah. We didn't find out how they became the strangers.
Nor
they
did
just,
we need to.
Yeah, but if that's how they're selling it, is like this is they're making, so this is going to be Stranger Chapter 1, Chapter 2 is coming out later in the year, and Chapter 3 is either coming out
next year.
Beginning of next year. They somebody bought them and they're like redistributing them or like rebooting them.
Yeah. I don't even know what to say. It was such a waste of time.
Yeah. The only thing I did think that was successful, the part where they're crawling under the house, because at least it was something. At least it was like, oh, we you know, did you ever watch Vacancy?
Yeah,
that was scary.
Yeah, I like that movie.
But at least that was something that we were, everything else, it literally was like beat by beat. And no shade, and again, we see too many trailers, but her leaning up against the window and then pulling her was in the trailer.
Yeah.
Her putting her face to the door and the axe coming through in the trailer. Her standing in the shower and she moves and the guy is there in the trailer.
Even the end.
Yeah, so it was like every beat of the movie that was scary, in quotes, was in the trailer.
You anticipated it.
Yeah, I wanted to love it though because I really do love The Strangers.
Yeah, the first one's really good, but this one didn't do it for me.
Will you see Chapter 2?
No.
What about Chapter 3?
No.
If they came back with a whole new Strangers.
Yes. Yeah. But if by some miracle Chapter 2 is like amazing or has great reviews, great. Yeah. I'll consider it.
Yeah. It really just wasn't scary.
No, not at all.
That's the thing. It's like it's such a simple concept. It needs to be scary.
Totally.
Okay, lastly, we are going to talk about The Poolman starring Chris Pine, Danny DeVito, Annette Bening, and our favorite from Imaginary, DeWanda Wise.
Oh my God. Not Imaginary Friend, Imaginary. Another movie about imaginary friends.
Yeah, 2 in 1 year, both
awful.
Painful. And I think I gave both of them 1 star or half a star. The pool man. Okay, I have to focus. The pool man is about a pool man that lives in an apartment building in L.A. who is like hippy-dippy, like environmentalist who like goes to the courthouse for like different causes.
L.A. purist is how I would put it.
Yes, L.A. That's a great way to put it.
Yeah.
L.A. purist who gets involved in this scheme with like corrupt politicians, mm-hmm. and he has to like solve it. It's like a noir. It's like a parody of like an old school like noir kind of movie.
I did sleep for 30 minutes or 40 minutes. The movie was 2 hours, so I saw the majority of it.
Okay.
Why'd you roll your eyes?
I didn't. I was looking at Patrick.
You rolled your eyes.
I did not. Adrian, why are you fighting with me? I didn't roll my eyes.
Here's Patrick put it perfectly. He said you could tell the cast was having so much fun.
1,000%.
And I totally agree with that. I don't ever need to see it again. Nobody will ever talk about it again. But yeah. It was fun enough.
Chris Pine wrote and directed, or co-wrote and then directed this movie. This is his directorial debut.
That's rough. Everybody has to start somewhere.
Everybody has to start somewhere. When you're Chris Pine, I expect more, I think.
Yeah.
But what a cast. I mean, Chris Pine, so he was, I will say this, for whatever the movie was, he is so likable.
You're right.
And it was a perfect example of him. You know, he always is doing these paparazzi photos of him. Or they're always taking these paparazzi photos of him in, like, very high-end pajamas or, like, teeny tiny shorts. He definitely thinks he has a nice butt because every other shot was his butt up close. But I was like, okay, so you're just trying to give yourself a different lane with this movie. This is a character you would never be cast as. Here you are, which I can appreciate. Annette Bening, super likable. Danny DeVito, super likable. So, you know.
Yeah.
At least he decorated it nicely. I didn't think it was very, I thought it was stupid.
You gave it how many stars?
I think 1.
That seems so incorrect.
Yeah. And that seems to be the theme for you and my opinions today, which is fine.
Like, what will you give The Strangers?
0.5 star.
So you think those movies are basically equatable?
I think The Pool Man was a very stupid movie.
Yeah.
But if you're really high, or Patrick, you will love it. Like, Patrick and 3 other people in the theater were laughing like it was... That's the hardest I've ever heard Patrick laugh at a movie.
That's not true. That can't be true.
Name another movie he's belly laughed at over and over.
Spy. Bros. That was
I wasn't here.
You weren't?
I wasn't here for that, so I miss that. But I'm glad to know.
Yeah.
We saw that guy.
Yeah, we did yesterday.
That's so wild.
Or 2 days ago, whenever that was.
Yeah. Yeah, anyway. So it maybe it's for some people. It definitely was not for me.
That's a good stupid way to put it. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I wanted to like, but like, I like Chris Pine. I thought he was doing fine. Sandy from Glee, he had some nice moments with him. Mm. That was the best part of the movie, I thought.
Oh, yeah, he was what, like the commissioner or whatever on the dais, whatever it was.
And their little scene at the end, I was like, okay, this is sweet. There is like some heart in it.
Whatever.
I don't know. 3 stars? I was like, wow, Adrian really liked this.
I didn't really like it. I just thought it was good. It was okay. 3 to me is okay. 2 is not great. 1, bad. 4, really good. 5, unbelievable.
3 to me is like, this is a good movie.
No. Nope.
So what is this is a good movie level to you?
Like 4. 3 is like, all right. It's like middle of the road.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I accept that.
Okay.
Anything else you want to say about The Pool Man?
No, but I do have a question that we can ask. It's an old one, but it's a good one.
Let's hear it. It's time for our question of the week. Adrian?
Should I say who it's from?
Yeah, why not?
I'm going to ask it first.
Okay.
And it's very topical.
Okay.
Do you think that Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce will last? Or do you think it will be like every other relationship she's had and he'll end up the subject of another hit song.
Oh my God.
You want me to tell you who wrote that?
Yes.
Your mother.
Mama. Okay, first of all, my mom is very removed from pop culture, so...
She is not incorrect, though.
She's not incorrect, but she did mention to me that they talk about their relationship on the local news.
Oh.
And she's like, why do they talk... So in that respect, I understand that it's annoying for her.
Yeah.
Or that she's like, this is silly.
Yeah.
Do I think Taylor and Travis will last? I mean, who's to say?
A part of me thinks yes.
Yeah.
Because it's, first of all, from a business perspective, very mutually beneficial for the both of them.
Mm-hmm.
But from the second part of me, they really do seem like they're into each other.
They definitely do. Yeah. I thought her and Joe,
yeah,
that in, from like, I obviously know I'm not too deep into it, so I don't know for sure, but like they seemed like the perfect, because she likes to be a little removed.
Yeah.
He likes to be a little removed. He's a respected actor. She's a respected musician. Yeah. So she definitely wants to date somebody who is like at the top of their game, mm-hmm. whatever their field of work is. Mm-hmm.
Maybe she needs like a plumber.
Yeah, but I think it's hard when you are that level of famous not to date somebody who is famous. Mm-hmm. Because Travis Kelce, even though his line of work is very different, mm-hmm. he understands adoration mm-hmm. And also they're not competing with each other, mm-hmm. you know?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
And he's had wild success himself.
I mean, literally he's won the Super Bowl multiple times.
Yeah.
I have no idea as the answer, but will he end up in an album? I did think it was weird that she put out an album. They've been together for a long time about what's his name from the 1975.
Yeah. Matty Healy.
Every time I listen to that album, I'm like, you're so happy. This album is so not.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
Love it.
Yeah.
Great question.
I like Taylor, though, and I will say this. I do think she... gets a bad rap with the boyfriend thing. Because, I mean, like, she just has been famous the whole, her dating life. Mm. So every time she dates somebody, even if it's for, like, a little bit, it is, you know, headline news.
Sure.
Most people date a lot of people in their life, or a lot of people date a lot of people. It's not anything she's doing as unnecessarily. Mm. Thank you so much for your question. If you have a question, you can call or leave us a voicemail or text us at 919-675-CHAT, which is 919-675-2428. Or you can email us at chatwithcurry@gmail.com or send us a message anywhere on our social media.
Or send a carrier pigeon.
Or you can send us a...
Did your teeth just whistle?
Yeah, they did just whistle. Also, are you proud of me? I said the number without stuttering.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Thank you.
That was pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. It is time for our songs of the week.
Mine is Stand In by Diva Mahal.
Careless. You were so careless with my heart. And you damn near. You damn near tore it apart. Told me you're loving, loving somebody else.
Somebody else.
But you still wanna keep me.
Is that the one you just played in the car?
For like 1 second.
I liked it. You were going through a lot of songs. So I was like, oh my God.
I know.
Gosh.
You know, I try to play like A&R. I'll go through like 100 songs to try to find something that I really like.
We really should have worked in A&R.
I know.
We still could. We're not dead.
We're not dead yet.
Not yet. God forbid. My song of the week is... How did you find that song, by the way?
It was maybe a few... It couldn't have been months ago. No, maybe it was a few months ago. It was on like a suggested playlist for me. But it's an old song. Came out in 2020.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
My song of the week is... I think I'm going to go with Lunch by Billie Eilish.
I could eat that girl for lunch. Yeah, she dances on my tongue. Tastes like she might be the one. And I could never get enough. I could buy her so much stuff. It's a craving, not a crush. Call me when you're there. I said I bought you something rare. And I left it under Claire. So now she's coming up the stairs. So I'm pulling up the chair. And I'm pulling up my hair.
Wow. Off of her new album that came out yesterday. Yesterday.
Wow.
Did you listen to any of it?
Not a single second.
I think it's her best album.
Really?
Here's what I do like about it. She is trying different things with her voice.
That's great.
So, like, if you go to see a concert, it doesn't all sound the same. There's a mix of styles. She has such a specific voice. It's a lot. It sounds sort of like Hayley Williams. Paramore, like the newer version of Paramore.
Yeah.
Where it's not like pop rock, it's more like alternative.
Sure.
That's kind of the vibe of it.
I like that.
But I do like it.
I'll give it a listen.
Yeah. Would you ever see her in concert?
Yeah, I would.
How much do you think the tickets are?
Like for where we sit?
Yeah.
75.
I want to go.
Did she announce a tour?
I think so. I haven't looked into it.
Oh, wow.
I'm just deciding right this moment I would like to go.
Great.
What are you looking forward to this coming week?
I'm going to Rhode Island. So we will not have a new podcast next week.
We are taking a break next week. We will be back the following week to talk about Furiosa,
mm-hmm.
the wedding that you went to,
mm-hmm.
Babes, which we're mm-hmm. seeing on Monday.
Mm-hmm. You know, we'll be jam-packed. That is what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah.
I'm only going for the weekend, but I think it's going to be fun.
You got a nice suit.
I have a nice suit. I have some nice clothes.
You're going to look great.
I'm excited. What about you?
I'm looking forward to us having coming back to where we can just enjoy each other's reviews and not be mad at each other. And you tell me I hate movies I don't hate.
Well, there is no confirming or denying that will ever happen again. I mean, it's very possible. I can almost guarantee it, actually. I will guarantee it. It will happen again. So just prepare yourself.
Say one thing nice about me.
You're fun to hang out with.
That is okay. I could cry. Thank you. We're going to end on that. Bye, y'all.
Oh, bye.
Thank you so much for listening to Let's Chat with Curry and Adrian. If you enjoyed the show, and we know you did, subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you listen. Don't forget to leave a 5-star review. Keep the conversation going by following me on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter at Curry Terrell, and Adrian on Instagram at Adrian McMill, and Twitter at Yo Adrian McMill. Discover our weekly song picks by adding our playlist on Spotify or Apple Music, all linked in this week's episode description. Got questions or feedback? Email us at letschatwithcurry@gmail.com. See you next time. Bye, y'all.